week at River Ridge. Spring is just around the corner. Well, maybe. It looks like some warm weather should be coming our way soon.
This week we will share results of Illinois History Fair, explain a new fifth grade band activity, as well as some feedback from Gossip Girl. We also have a special segment this week from Ashley on some pretty awesome achievements of the Flat Boys. Every year, juniors have the opportunity to participate in Illinois History Fair, where they choose a local historical topic to further research. Then, they complete a detailed video with interviews and pictures to give the audience a full understanding of the topic. Last weekend, the students went to Northern Illinois to present their projects to the judges. All five groups that went were awarded and will advance to state in Springfield in hopes of winning a superior. Groups feel very relieved that all their hard work has paid off this year. Now here's to Carrie with a few Illinois History Fair members.
Thanks, Alyssa. I'm here with Kayla Brotzman and Abigail Green. So what was the title of your project?
The title of our project was The Woman of the Apple River Fort.
And how long did it take to do your project?
We started in August and ended like at least 2 weeks ago, probably.
So it took a while.
Yeah.
And how did you guys do at the competition?
Well, we qualified for state with four other groups, so we're pretty proud.
Congratulations. And were you surprised?
Oh, yes, definitely.
All right, back to the girls in the newsroom.
Fifth grade is a really great year for the boys and girls to get an interest in sports as well as the music department. Most recently, fifth grade band members had the opportunity to be chosen to play at Coe College. The composer from the college elected six members based off a short overview from Mrs. Schultz. Chosen students include Libby Schallenberger, Katie Coggy, Danae Kloss, Sarah Pratt, Kaylin Lord, and Riley Finn. They'll be attending an all-day event to practice and perform a program. Congratulations. And now, here's to Lauren.
Thanks, Kelsey. I'm here with Mrs. Schultz. So what is this honor band for the fifth graders?
An honor band is a big group of students who are selected of the top of each of their own school band, and they are able to play all day together and then perform a concert in the evening.
That's cool. When does this occur?
It'll be on April 5th at Coe College.
Okay, thank you. And who are some of the people in this honor band?
The students selected were Greta Dittmer, Riley Finn, Katie Coggy, Danae Kloss, Kaylin Lord, Sarah Pratt, and Libby Schellenberger.
Okay, thank you, and I hope this goes really well. I'm here with Riley Finn, Sarah Pratt, and Danae Kloss, all members of the 5th grade honor band. What instruments do you guys play?
I play the trumpet.
I play the clarinet.
I play the clarinet.
And what's your favorite part about band?
My favorite part about band is like being with Miss Schultz and like playing my trumpet and stuff.
My favorite part is being with my friends and just playing an instrument.
My favorite part is being with my friends and that I get to play the clarinet.
And are you guys excited for this honor band?
Definitely.
Totally.
Yeah.
Okay, back to the girls in the newsroom.
We really enjoy sharing our Gossip Girl sessions with our viewers. Even more so, we love hearing all the feedback of what you think. Here's some feedback from the most recent session.
I'm here with Jackie Pagor, who's currently taking care of her baby that was just crying. So, you probably saw last week's newscast. What did you think about our debate?
To be honest, I think it kind of gives a brief, like, what parenthood is like in high school. Because, like, it cries, and you have to feed it, and, like, the diaper change, like, not just plug keys in it. So it kind of, I don't know, I guess.
Thank you. Here with Kira Grimes, who has some words about our debate.
Baby project or not, kids are bad news.
Fair enough. Well said. Now I'm here with Carter Fleck. What are some of your opinions about the baby project?
I'm not looking forward to it.
All right. Now back to the girls in the newsroom.
Thanks for the feedback. And now here's to sports and our special news from Ashley.
Thanks, girls. With all the expected hype from the boys' basketball team, some people forget to realize that there is one other winter sport going along. That winter sport happens to be skiing. And this week, we have a short documentary about two of our high school skiers and what they have accomplished this year.
Both Hanover, Illinois natives, brothers Carter and Caleb Flack, grew up with skiing in their blood. The boys' dad, Todd, competed in the Pershell Pro Tour and was a part of the FIS racing team and competed in the USSA national competition. Growing up in a skiing family, Carter put on his first pair of skis at only 2 years old and joined the Chestnut Mountain race team at age five. At age five, Carter also competed in his first race. Carter now competes in the Giant Slalom and Slalom events.
Slalom, you make more quick turns. The turns are really short and kind of quick. GSs are more long and smooth lines.
In 2012, won second place at the NASTAR Nationals Race of Champions, which are the finals for the competition.
It was really surprising because I didn't think I was going to win. There's a lot of good people there.
Now a senior in high school, Carter recently claimed the title of leading point scorer for the Wajara League and also received the Shelley Glover Award for his passion for skiing and dedication to the sport.
I haven't won about four races this year in Wajara, so I kind of expected it. Shelley Glover was a surprise. My coach has nominated me for it.
Carter will be spending much of this month and part of the next month preparing for two final competitions. Carter will head down to Aspen, Colorado for the NASTAR Nationals competition from March 27th to March 30th.
This is going to be a big race. Over 3,000 people are going to be there, and there's going to be cameras everywhere.
And we'll spend April 12th through 13th competing in the Loveland Derby in Loveland, Colorado.
Biggest amateur race in North America, 500 people. It's going to be fun.
After graduation, Carter hopes to continue racing in college and continue FIS racing.
Hope to get on a good NCAA team or a big college somewhere. This racing is going to be harder. If I do it, I'm going to try and do Super G and downhill. But if that doesn't work out, I'll still stick to Slalom and GS.
Just like his brother, Caleb also began skiing at age two.
I started skiing when I was two because my dad was always big into skiing and his dad before him. And the first thing he got us to do was join the Chestnut Mountain race team.
Caleb began his career on the Chestnut Mountain race team like his brother, but ended racing in eighth grade in order to shift his focus to freestyle skiing. Freestyle skiing is where Caleb has found his comfort. He has executed a double front flip, which he considers to be one of his biggest accomplishments thus far, even though he lost his ski while attempting to stick the landing.
Well, it was all because of the Big Nut competition. I wanted to win really bad, so me and my friends started talking about doing some pretty insane tricks, like doubles. So we went up to Tyrol Basin in Wisconsin, Mount Horeb. They have an airbag, so we started practicing there. But I never really did the double front flip there. So we came to Big Nut on the slopestyle course, and we just talked about it for a real long time, and I just decided to do it.
Caleb also competed in the 6th annual Big Nut Open at Chestnut Mountain Resort this past weekend. Caleb was the overall first place winner after winning first place in the slope style event and big air portions, and third place in the rail jam portion of the competition.
It's pretty much the wrap-up competition. It's really big. People from all over, like, our area come. There's three competitions, the rail jam, the big air, the slope style. Slope style is the funnest because that's the rail jam, big air, and everything mixed together. Big air is just the jumps, and then rail jam is just the rails.
For winning first place, Caleb received three shirts, two bandanas, two sweatshirts, two hats, Bolle sunglasses, Alon skis, gloves, and various stickers from the sponsors. With his season winding down, Caleb is looking to the future with hopes of becoming sponsored and winning a lot of money to help him continue to compete for years to come.
Future, I hope to get sponsored, win money, keep competing, ski with friends as long as I can.
Both Carter and Caleb Flack have accomplished so many things this year that are worth recognition throughout the communities.
So Katie, what's been going on with the boys' basketball team? This week, the boys had their sectional game on Tuesday night. But before talking about that, I would like to do a quick review of the extremely intense regional championship game last Friday against the East Dubuque Warriors, where the boys only won by 1 point in overtime. In the last seconds of overtime, Josh Chris caught the ball and put it through the hoop, winning the Wildcats' second regional championship in a row. Here's a recap of that game.
Boys start out good. Dauphin gets the rebound and scores a nice 3-point shot.
Here comes Dolphin scores for three.
Josh snatches the ball from the Warriors. And the Cats work the ball around for Sam to get the basket.
Here comes Clifford. Good bounce pass by Clifford. Good job by Clifford all the way. He steals it and gets the assist into Sam Merkel.
Austin Durr gets hammered. These are the most amazing and longest free throws Riveridge has ever seen. And it goes in. Still bouncing. And they both go in, putting Riveridge down only by one in overtime. Riveridge only had 7 seconds to make a basket for the win. Brendan takes the ball down the floor, the ball bounces off the rim, and into the hands of Josh, who scores the winning bucket for Riveridge's second regional championship win over East Dubuque in a row.
The boys won the exciting regional championship game, 50-49. Then on Tuesday, the boys went on to play the Indian Creek Timberwolves in a sectional game where unfortunately their season came to an end. The score of that final game was 41-59. We are proud of all the boys for the dedication they put in this year, and thank you to the seniors for the leadership they provided to the team. Good luck next year. We hope you all will go just as far.
Thanks, Katie. Now back to the girls.
Wow, good luck, boys, in the future. And now here's to Kelly with this week's weather.
Sunny and 75. Just kidding. Today there is a high of 32 with a low of 12, cloudy. Saturday is a high of 26 and a low of 9, partly cloudy. Sunday is a high of 21 and a low of 5, partly cloudy. And Monday is a high of 17 with a low of 5, partly sunny. Back to you guys.
Now here's a word from our sponsors.
What's better, bigger or smaller?
Bigger!
What's the biggest number of senior candy bars you can eat?
1,000,000,000,000,000,000,000!
That's pretty big. How about you?
10.
Okay, how about you?
Infinity!
That's a lot.
Infinity in one!
Actually, the answer we're looking for is infinity plus infinity.
What about infinity times infinity?
Now here's to current events.
Hi, I'm Kyle Wrights, and this is current events. First, Lady Michelle Obama isn't going to be happy. According to the new study, not enough 12 to 15-year-olds are participating in her Let's Move campaign to end childhood obesity. Only one in four gets the recommended 60 minutes of physical activity a day.
Dang.
Yeah.
One of the world's most dangerous animals doesn't have big teeth or sharp claws. It's the mosquito. Some of these bloodsuckers can carry deadly diseases, including malaria, which killed nearly 630,000 people in 2012. Most people at risk for malaria live in the tropics, where hot, humid climates provides an ideal breeding ground for these pests. On average, a child in Africa dies from the disease every minute. For years, one of the most effective ways to prevent malaria, which causes fever, headache, and chills, has been for people in affected areas to sleep under nets treated with insecticides. But scientists are now experimenting with a different approach, changing the DNA of wild mosquitoes so that eventually they'll be unable to transmit the disease. And we're current events.
Thanks, boys. And now here's to Erin with this week's announcements.
Thanks, girls. Not too many announcements this week, but first off, congratulations to all 5 Illinois History Fair groups for making it into state. Great job, guys. Mr. Downs wants to remind Western Civ and current events you have a 9-week project coming up, and that sociology has a test on Chapter 9 next week. Back to you, girls.
I was going to say, maybe you should say something about the boys.
Like what?
I don't know, just...
Thanks, Aaron. Now here's to Mr. Van Gogh's joke.
The other day, my friend was about to get attacked by a duck. I tried to warn him, but it just made matters worse.
Well, we hope everyone enjoys their weekend as we're already into the second weekend of March.
Thanks for watching, and as always, we'll try to do better next week.
If you close your eyes.